Anyway, so back to this. So he lost his virginity 2 years ago because a girl that he'd been in love with since high school walked up to him in a bar, grabbed his dick, and went, toilet. And, you know, God's love is good, but it's not as good as, you know, fucking a girl in a handicap toilet, so. So I've been told. And so now he's out there on the prowl, and he's 30, but he's, you know, he hits on chicks like he's a 12-year-old. No. That sounds creepier than it was. Like, he's not going up to them on a big wheel, being like, hey, I just learned about masturbation. Would you like me to, like... Anyway, he just gets excited anytime he gets laid. So about 3 months ago, I awoke to the following text message. John, wake up! That's a text message. He has a PhD in English literature. He's been flown around the world to talk about Queen Elizabeth I and how her teachings relate to metaphor in the English language. And he thought he could wake me up with a fucking text message. Wake up! If you don't wake up, you're gay. I need to explain. That sounds homophobic, and it is. And the reason why that is that Canada, we just got homophobia. Like, it happened this year. You've been allowed as a gay person to get married since 2003. You're totally within your rights. Equal marriage totally exists in Canada. But if you are skating and you're not playing hockey, that's deemed as being gay. So I was at the Dom last night, right? The Dom is our local bar. It's like this room, if this room was painted black and smelled like a hamster cage, and there were just picnic tables. That should tell you how seedy it is that they've put outdoor furniture inside. And the problem with drinking near a picnic, on a picnic table is you can never leave in a huff, you know what I mean? Like this kind of chair, you can get fucked, Dave! That works. Picnic table doesn't work. You can get fucked, Dave. So I'm at the Dom, right? And oh fuck, this is being taped. I should change your name. probably could have just fuck. Let's try that again, shall we? Lisa. Thank you. That's why they call me the transition kid. Anyway, so Lisa is at the bar and she's rubbing my arm. You know how they do. I agree, quite creepy. That's smooth as the Lisa transition. Fuck! Guess this will be marked as private on YouTube. Anyway, so she's rubbing my arm, so I know she wants me to take her to Fuck City. PhD in English, and you can see why, right? So we drove out to the old farm, and she gave me a blowy J that could bring the cows home. Now, I don't know if that is a metaphor, because they were at an abandoned farm. Did she suck his dick so good, cows appeared? Because if that's true, she could be used to help rejuvenate farms all over the world. We haven't been able to get livestock to exist here. That woman's going to suck that guy's dick, and you're going to see some magic happen. And she looked at me and just went, just to let you know, I've been working as an escort for the last 6 months. First one's free. It's a little sad. Now, what's funny is that we know Lisa, because we know her through her older brother. And this message was sent to me in a WhatsApp group that her older brother is a part of. And he chimes in with, telling me my sister is a prostitute? Torts. I think you're missing the point here. I got an escort to suck my dick for free.